Hello, everyone. I am praying that if you are watching this as a replay, that the power of God will hit you as if you were live with us. Come on in, everyone. I'm going to wait for Facebook to come in and build an audience. I know it's a bunch of you that are working right now. But there is a message, people of God, for the Rabakoshaya, for the people of God that are tuning in right now. It's not by coincidence that you are here. It's not by coincidence that in the middle of the day, people of God, you are tuned in. Come on in. Come on today, people of God. We're going to clear up some things. Today, I have a few things that I need to say, because sometimes you got to set clarity, hallelujah, in the atmosphere. And what I am learning, people of God, is as Christian people, sometimes, watch this, we are told that we cannot set the record straight. The devil is a liar. So come on in. I got some things to say. Come on. Eyes have not seen nor ears have heard what God wants to do in you and through you. Come on, people of God, but there is something, hallelujah, excuse me, thank you, Jesus, that has to be said. Come on, the quicker everybody begin to come in and begin to tag and share, the quicker, people of God, that God can be getting to just have his way on today. Just give me a second, because I'm tagging some people to this live also. If you can come in and begin to drop in the comment section, come on, at everyone, at followers, at highlights. I truly believe this, people of God, and I'm going to say it because you know how I feel. I'm going to say how I feel. I'm going to give you realness. I'm going to keep it real. I truly believe that people think because you are saved, that I'm about to say, that you're not about, you're not supposed to set the record straight. I think that people truly believe that because you go to church and because you love God, that you can't put people in their place. I truly think that people believe that the moment you receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior, all the gangster in you go away. No, the devil is a liar. Come on in, people of God. There's a word. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. I need you to begin to tag and share. Let me use my other phone and begin to tag and share. And I pray over this live right now because I know some people going to feel some kind of way, but I'm up for the challenge. Come on in, people of God, and begin to tag and share. Please don't come in just watching. The quicker you begin to tag others, the quicker you begin to tag and share, people of God, glory be to God, the quicker, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, that we can go ahead and get started with our live. Just give me a second, people of God. I'm inviting some people to this live so the numbers can begin to move. And some people, they will catch it a little bit later because they're working. But today we're definitely setting the record straight. Come on in, everyone. Glory be to God. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, and begin to tag and share. Give me a second. Give me a second. I'm inviting some people. Glory to God to this live. You'll see the numbers starting to move. Blessings to everyone who's obedient. Let me tell you something. Baby, this is going to be the live you want to tag and share. Because sometimes you got to remind people that you saved, but you're not soft. Come on in and begin to tag and share. There are some of you, you're going through things with people on your job. There are some of you who are going through things with people on social media. There are some of you, people of God, who are going through things with people in your own family. Come on, there are some of you, people of God, you're going through things with people you once loved and you once cared about. And the Lord began to give me a message on today that I am excited about. Let me go ahead and start TikTok. Because when I tell you I feel God right now, baby, when I tell you the enemy is going to be upset after this live, come on in and tag and share, people of God. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on in, please, and tag and share. Come on, I just started TikTok also, so just give me a few seconds. I think it's been a minute since I got to literally come on here and put demons in their places. But I think today is going to be the live that I do so. Come on in, everybody, and begin to tag and share. Come on, come on, come on. Everybody on Facebook, just give me a few minutes, maybe 2 more minutes, because TikTok is building an audience. Come on in, everybody. This is the live. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, that you might want to share to remind your enemies, hallelujah, that you're saved, but you're not soft. This is the live, people of God, that you might want to tag others to remind people, come on, you can be nice, but don't get it twisted. You're still in between. Praise is what I do and knock if you buck. This is the live, people of God, and I'm a Josiah, where you might, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, glory be to God, want to let other people know that I came from this. I know you see me as humble right now, but I came from this. I know you see me as a person that, you know, is a little more soft spoken because I was a little rough back in the days. But I came from this. To you, the one that's watching this video, today's message is it's non-negotiable. I want everybody to drop that in the comment section. It's non-negotiable. It's non-negotiable. And I promise you I'm finna get into the message. I was just sitting back, people of God, and I'm literally just thinking about how sometimes the enemy will use people to test you, watch this, to see if you still got that little oomph in you. People always say, listen, when people say they love God and people going to church and this and this and that, they shouldn't get angry, they shouldn't get upset, they shouldn't be out here fighting, they shouldn't respond. But at the end of the day, we're all human. Even Jesus got mad and walked in the temple and started flipping over tables. What you talking about? Peter in the Bible cut a man's ear off. I just gotta take a moment, for a moment, people of God, and just begin to lay this foundation. And then I'm gonna give somebody courage on today. Don't let people play with your gangster. It's non-negotiable. There are some of you that are watching. People are taking advantage of you and treating you any kind of way. Hallelujah. Because they feel like you've leveled up from the person who would have been put there. Oh, Jesus Christ. Been put your hands on them. There are some of you that are watching. The reason you are, watch this, the target. The reason you are the person that people think is somebody to play with. Because they know you're trying your best to change your life. Oh, somebody got to be feeling me right now. You ought to put in the comment section, I'm trying. I'm trying my best not to respond. This lie, people of God, is to remind the devil that certain things are non-negotiable. I have always said one thing and one thing only. Baby, it's never the problem. It's the principle. Somebody drop that in the comment section. It's the principle. Come on, it's the principle. See, give me a second and I'm going to say what the pastor afraid to say, or what the apostle and what the prophet and different people, they're afraid to say. Come on, even though they're feeling certain ways, sometimes, watch this, people of God, they're afraid to say how they actually, glory be to God, how they actually feel. But there are sometimes, and it comes to a point in time sometimes, people of God, why you gotta get to a place the way you say, I pray, but I ain't nothing to play with. Somebody ought to drop that in the comment section. I ain't nothing to play with. People don't understand. It's not the problem, it's the principle. The Lord began to tell me today's message, people of God, was it's non-negotiable. When I began to look up the definition of the word, whatever, Josiah, the word negotiable, people of God, it said there, watch this, something that's up for discussion. I need y'all to catch this really quickly. See, a lot of y'all go amen and hallelujah a little bit later on. But there are some of us who are in a place in our lives where we're saying we're trying everything to stay safe. But I need you not to forget. I looked up the word negotiable. And it said something that's up for discussion. And something that's up for debate. I don't know who needs to hear this message right now, but the Lord is saying there are some things that are non-negotiable for you in this season. The Lord is saying, watch this. There are some things that are non-negotiable. That means it's not up for debate. That means it's nothing to talk about. That means you ain't going back and forth about it. That means that it's not up for discussion at all. Y'all got to understand that the devil will use any and everybody to try to get you off folks, off focus. The devil will use any and everybody, you better get what I'm saying, to get you, hallelujah, to get off track. Anytime you are going to another level, people of God, the enemy is going to send his imp to the Makoshaya to try to disturb your peace. Somebody put in the comment section, I got a sound mind. Watch this. When you are saying that you are focused on doing right, when you are saying that you are focused on keeping your hands to yourself, when you are finally saying that you are focused, my God, of being the best version of you, the devil gonna send his imps. Let me tell you what I am learning, people of God. When you are a threat, somebody ought to put in the comment section, I'm a threat. When you are a threat, people of God, to the enemy and his camp, you better hear what I'm saying. The target becomes, watch this, on your back. When you are a threat to the enemy or his camp, you become a target. This is why, people of God, there are some of you that have been finding yourself a lot angrier than you usually are lately. This is why, people of God, there are some of you that are watching. Lately, you've been finding yourself with no patience. This is why, people of God, there are some of you who are watching. And lately, you haven't been wanting to deal with people, because people have caused you to go back. Somebody ought to just clarify that I ain't speaking to myself and I ain't lying, and you ought to drop in the comment section, people been trying me. There are some of you as people on your job. There are some of you as people in your church. There are some of you as people in your household. There are some of you that it's people that you call friends. There are some of you, it's people that carry your same last name. But the Lord is saying, hear me and hear me well. In this season, there are certain things that are non-negotiable. What do you mean, Dr. Shakir McFadden? The enemy know don't play with two things, my husband or my children. What is your non-negotiable? God began to say to me that people, they tend to forget. This is why there are so many of you that are being looked down on. This is why there are so many of you, you got people around you that are highlighting things that you did 4-5 years ago. This is why, there are some of you that are watching. You got people, hallelujah, still speaking on your past. God told me to come and tell you, the one that's watching this video, there are certain things that are non-negotiable. Somebody put in the comment section, like my character. People tend to forget where the Lord brought you from. People tend to think, hey, Apostle Faith. People tend to think, people of God, that you don't know how to slay demons in the spiritual realm. I remember, people of God, when I was in the world, I would fight at the drop of a dime. If I can be honest with you, the church that I spent almost 15 years at, when my pastor, hallelujah, when I got out from behind bars, they caught me and my husband and some of our family members out fighting some other people, and I was fighting somebody who was pregnant. Back then, baby, I was reckless and didn't care. I don't care if you was 8 or 80. You know what I'm saying? I got a mentality that when people got in front of me that disrespected me, all I seen was red. But then I leveled up. Somebody dropped that in the comment section. But then I leveled up. And as you begin to level up, people of God, there are going to be people that the enemy use to try to trigger the old you. You saved. You shouldn't respond that way. You You saved it. You shouldn't be around here angry. You saved it. You shouldn't have to put people in their place. The devil is a liar. Disrespect is non-negotiable. There are some of you that are watching this live right now. I guarantee you, if you take a moment and you begin to walk through your household and you begin to tell every spirit that lingers there with chaos or anything you got going on, hallelujah, in your household, whether it's struggling with bills or whatever you're struggling with, whatever is causing a problem in your zip code, where you reside, I dare you to just walk through the house and tell the enemy you cannot resign here, because it's non-negotiable. To negotiate means to discuss, to debate. But when you begin to say something that is non-negotiable, people of God, that means, watch this, it's nothing we need to talk about. Period. There are some of you people of God, I really need you to get this in your spirit, because as you begin to do something different, as you begin to say, I don't care what standard you hold me to, I am in a place in my life where there are things I'm no longer putting up with. There are some of you people of God, you've been allowing the enemy to beat you down the last year, 2 years, 3 years. At what point do you get up and you say, this thing is not up for debate anymore. It's non-negotiable. Satan, you won't attack my finances anymore. It's non-negotiable. Satan, you won't have my children anymore. It's non-negotiable. Satan, you can't have my mind anymore. It's non-negotiable. It's not by coincidence that you are on this live right now. It's not by coincidence that you are on this live right now. I had a little situation that it went on a couple days ago, and you know, I received a crazy text today, and my mind, if I could be honest with you, wanted to say, let me show this person I ain't nothing to play with. But the Lord began to say to me that you've already leveled up from that level. So I began to say to God, God, you knew me before you created me. You know that I'm in between knuck if you buck and praise is what I do. You know what you brought me from up out of. And I begin to say to God that certain things are non-negotiable. And the Lord began to say this to me. Take the same energy that you want to put out right now and put it into knocking the devil down. As the Lord begin to say to me, watch this. He began to say that certain things, hear me and hear me well, are non-negotiable. And as the Lord began to say that to me, I don't know who I'm speaking to right now. The Lord began to say to me that I created you. Hallelujah. Even when you was out fighting in the streets, even when you was trying to prove a point, even when you were letting people know you wasn't nothing to mess with, he began to say to me, now I've added the anointing to your life. And because I've added the anointing to your life, you are now a shaker and a mover. So you got to fight this thing a different way. I don't know who I'm speaking to right now, but baby, you better fight with all you got in a different way. What are you saying, Dr. Shakira McFadden? The Lord began to say that we are created to be shakers and movers. Whatever goes shy, people in this season better watch how they put their mouth on you. People in this season better watch what they say to you. People in this season better be careful how they treat you. Why? Because God has created you to be a shaker and a mover. If you're just now tuned in, people of God, today's message, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, it's non-negotiable. There are certain things. Watch this. We want to show people we're nothing to play with. And the Lord is saying, watch this. You got to use Rabba Kosaya, that same energy against the enemy. There are some people out there who are so mentally crazy that they can't even see they're being used by the devil. There are people out there who are literally so miserable. I'm telling you, you can be living your best life, and out the blue, they'll contact you with foolishness. And it's like, what? You ain't got nothing else better to do with your time, because life is good over here. Somebody ought to put that in the comment section. Life is good over here. A shaker is somebody that when you walk in the room, hallelujah, you shake the atmosphere. A shaker is somebody. If you watch this, if you step in a room and everything is going bad, because you know that favor follows you, when you get there, things begin to change. A shaker is a changer, a atmosphere changer. So I begin to say, watch this. Certain things is non-negotiable. When Jesus walked inside the temple and he was displeased with what they was doing, he flipped over tables. He was on his gangster stuff. Don't let nobody tell you in this season that you are this person and you are that person because you get angry. No. If I don't like what you're doing, you better let me flip a table. Because I'm in between. Praise is what I do. And not if you buck, I'm not lying to you. I am learning that when you decide to get in your error, where you saying I'm bigger and I'm better than fighting, I'm bigger and I'm better than cussing people out, I'm bigger and I'm better than people, you know, the old person that I used to be, I'm bigger and better than having to get locked up for violent charges, I'm bigger and better than busting out your cars, I'm bigger and better than exposing you on social media. When people see you like that, they'll try you even the more. So it's never the problem, it's the principle. Somebody drop that in the comment section. It's the principle. I am in a place in my life, people of God, I'm trying to tell you the truth. You've got to be really, 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 really careful with the way you treat people in this season. Especially when it's people who are favored by God. The time I turn around, I hear people say, oh, she a Christian and she went off on that person like that. He a Christian and he went off. What you want them to do? They love God, but you steady poking. You got to be all this poking. You got to be, baby, you got to be careful. Mess around and poke the wrong way, and then you get a different type of hands laid on you. Certain things are non-negotiable. It's not up for debate. I don't want to talk about it. We can't discuss it. And God began to tell me, instead of responding, you got to get to a place where you begin to give the enemy that same energy. This is why people of God, witches and warlocks, watch this. They're threatened by when you begin, Jesus Christ, when you begin to get mad. Witches and warlocks, hallelujah. They're threatened, hallelujah. Who am I speaking to? People of God, by people who call on the name of Jesus, witches and warlocks. They fear the anointing that you carry. You think that I'm going to come from the streets and be out there fighting and doing this and doing that. And then when I get in the kingdom of God, I'm soft? No, I ain't soft. I'm just respecting the oil. Somebody drop that in the comments. I'm respecting the oil. I know there's a call on my life and I want God to do great things in my life. I'm trying to respect the oil. Some of y'all say, well, I ain't from the hood and I can't relate. What? When them teachers was going off on your children and you had to go inside the classroom and let the teacher know, I ain't nothing to play with. You better play with anybody else's child in this class but mine. Could you relate to that? There are certain things that are non-negotiable. So instead of responding to people, deal with the spirit behind the people. Instead of responding to people, deal with the spirit behind the people. Baby, me dealing with you, you ain't even on my level. I'ma deal with the spirit behind you. Because it got a little more power than you. You don't even realize that you're being used by the enemy. So I'm going to spare you, but I'm going to deal with the demon that's operating through you. The Lord said today's message was it's non-negotiable. There are some of you, if you took the time, to back up demons, hallelujah, that are interfering with your relationship or interfering with your marriage. Who am I speaking to? Things can begin to change. You are so busy fighting and swinging at the wrong person. It's not the person, it's the spirit behind the person. There are some of you, every time you walk on your job, you miserable. Because there are people who want you fired for no reason at all. Maybe certain things are non-negotiable. You no longer have to deal with them. You're dealing with the spirit behind them. Said, God, this season I've been in lately, I've been allowing things to be up for debate. I said, God... This season I've been in lately, it's been a lot of back and forth. And you got to explain why you making this move, why you did that. You got to explain and defend yourself, why you reacted this way, why you reacted that way. There are certain things in 2024 that are no longer negotiable. When the enemy's coming to interrupt your peace, baby, that is no longer up for debate. There are some of you, I'm telling you, literally, you need to walk through your household and decree in the atmosphere. Devil, I am giving you an eviction notice. You can no longer resign here. Satan, I'm telling you, you got to go. This thing is no longer up for debate. It's non-negotiable. Whatever you're believing God for, whatever you're believing God for, hear me and hear me well on today, people of God. The Lord is saying, whatever you are believing Him for, you got to stand on faith about it. That's the problem with the people of God. We don't stand on business no more. I told my husband the other day, when it comes to Jehovah Witnesses, they stand together. They knock on your doors, passing out watchtowers, rain, snow, sleet or fall. When you look at the Israelites, they stand together as one, standing on the corner of the street, preaching what they believe in. But us Christians, we don't stand on nothing. If you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. I don't know what you've been believing God for, but I'm gonna need you to stand on business. I don't know what you're believing God for, but I'm gonna need you to stand on business. It's never the problem, it's the principle. Satan, I don't got a problem with you attacking me bill-wise. I don't got a problem, glory be to God, with having to live paycheck to paycheck for the moment. The principle is, you don't know the God I serve. It's never the problem. It's the principle. Who am I speaking for today? God is saying, begin to stand on it. Certain things is going to be non-negotiable in 2024. We are halfway through the year, and some of y'all fighting the same demons. Don't get mad. What you mean, don't get mad? When I'm going through trials and tribulations, Jesus flipped over a table. I be wanting to flip people over. Can I just be real with you? Certain ministers won't keep it real with you, but I'm the type of minister that'll keep it real with you. What do you mean, don't cry? You better let me cry so I can, I don't know about you, but baby, back in the days when I was in high school, they already knew, baby, if you see me crying, huffing and puffing, when I'm crying, baby, it's going down. You better let me cry so I can release some of the stress I got. In this season, I need you to remember, it's never the problem, it's the principle. People will take you through hell and back. People will take you through hell and back. People will drive you crazy if you continue to give them the keys. At some point, you got to begin to say, people of God, my peace is non-negotiable. You got to begin to tell the enemy, people of God, struggling is a non-negotiable thing for me. I know that I'm blessed by the high God. I know that I'm God's favorite. So if I'm struggling for this moment financially, it's only temporarily. Who am I speaking to? The Lord gave me this scripture that I wanted to share with you. Psalms 23 and 5 says this, people of God. It says that you will prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. When I read that scripture, I'm going to bless somebody with this. Because for a long time, baby, I've been reading the Bible ever since I was locked up. Let me tell you one thing about a person who done did a lot of time. That's the only free book they give you. So we know the Bible back and forth. Watch this. Psalm 23 and 5 says this. I know the Bible back and forth, but I never got this revelation of it that God gave me today until he gave me this word on today. Psalms 23 and 5 says this. You'll prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You'll anoint my head with oil, and then my cup will overflow. Every time I read that scripture, people of God, I see myself sitting at the table with all the people I don't like. I seen God, he's making a way out of no way from me. Watch this, before my enemies. But the Lord gave me a different revelation of it on today for you, the one that's watching this video. Sometimes your enemies is not a physical person. I need y'all to catch this. Sometimes your enemies, is not a physical person. Psalm 23 and 5 says, you prepare a table for me in the presence of my enemies. I'm going to give you a different way that the Lord gave me to look at it. God can, he'll prepare a table for you in the presence of your bills. He'll prepare a table for you in the presence, hallelujah, of that Jezebel that's trying to come between you and your man's relationship. He'll prepare a table in the presence of that sickness you're going through in your body. Be healed in the name of Jesus. He'll prepare a table in the presence of those suicidal thoughts and that depression you're going through. He'll prepare a table in the presence of the judge. And I'm a Koshaya. God is saying, I'll prepare a table in the presence of your enemy. Your enemy is anything that is causing you to lose your everlasting mind. Your enemy is anything that is causing you to want to give up. Your enemy is anything that is causing you to get out of character. Man, when the Lord gave me the revelation of that today, I begin to see things different. I got more excited about the feast that was about to take place. Somebody drop in the comment section, it ain't even Thanksgiving. Jesus Christ. One thing I love about God, baby, is he'll bless you and you ain't even sneezing. I just said, when I read this scripture, I begin to prepare for the feast. And it ain't even Thanksgiving time. I begin to see, Rabbi Goshia, what was sitting at my table. The mountains that tried to break me down. The things that tried to destroy me. There are some of you at your table, baby. It's going to be car keys and house keys. There are some of you at your table, Rabbi Goshia. Let me tell you, it's going to be your own credit score. There are some of you at your table. Hear me and give me, people of God. It's going to be the own children you birth. I said what I said. There are some of you at your table. It's going to be your own family members. Your enemies. The people that are trying to drive you crazy. The situations that are trying to take you out. God is saying, Rabakosaya, the feast is taking place. And it's not even November or December. It ain't even Thanksgiving or Christmas. But the way God is about to bless you, watch this, it's non-negotiable. What are you saying, Dr. Shakira McFadden? The witches can burn your name with candles on it. This next blessing is non-negotiable. They can do whatever they want to do. They can call, I just heard this in the spiritual realm. They can try to get your kids taken from you. The way God is going to bless you is non-negotiable. They can try to come in between you and your relationship, but the way God is about to do it for you, thank you for all the gifts on TikTok, it's non-negotiable. That means it's not up for debate. It's not up for debate. The Bible says you prepare a table for me in the presence of my enemies. And then you'll anoint my head with oil and my cup will overflow. That means whatever that is at your table is about to see the outpouring. They're about to see the overflow. They're about to watch you go from getting paycheck advance and having to borrow money and living paycheck to paycheck to experiencing the overflow where you have more than enough. Huh? What does that mean, Dr. Shakira McFadden? They're about to watch you go from taking all kind of medications and all kind of pills, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, to not needing whatever Goshiah, any script, hallelujah. They're about to watch you go from taking all this medication to calm down your anxiety, to Goshiah, to watch this, walking this thing out. Somebody put in the comment section, it's all at the table. I've seen some people put on TikTok, I got chills right now from watching this. That means that this live was for you. You could be praying for God to give you clarity on something, and then out of the blue, Rabbi Goshiah, he'll come through and give you clarity. The Lord is saying, there are things in this season, it's non-negotiable. It's no longer up for debate. The Lord also told me to give you, people of God, Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 2. And it says this, if you listen obediently to the voice of God, your God, and you obey all his commands, God, your God, will place you high above the nations and of the world. He'll make your name great. Somebody put that in the comment section with their name. Shakira's name shall be great. I want you to put your own name there. I can't type because I'm preaching. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. I want you to drop it there. Come on, Kay Bella, your name shall be great. Come on, decree that over yourself. It's not up for debate because the Lord is saying as long as you come, hallelujah, as long as you keep his commandments, there is nothing he won't do for you. My name is about to be, oh Jesus Christ, made great. There are some of you, you need to put your significant other's name in the comment section, your children's name in the comment section. God is about to make it great. Kellyanne, your name's about to be made greater. Tamia, your name's about to be made greater. Come on, Lakeisha, your name's about to be made greater. Kwan, your name's about to be made great. There are things in this season, baby, it's non-negotiable. It's non-negotiable. The Lord told me to also give you Genesis chapter 12, verse 2. I'm going to give you one more scripture after this because I have to jump on a counseling session with one of my clients. But Genesis, people of God, chapter 12, verse 2 says this, I will make you into a great nation and I will bless you. I will make your name great and you will be a blessing. There is two scripture back to back that confirms that God is about to do great things in you. They might know you as the person who never had money and always begging. They might know you as the person who were told that you got a sickness that is non-curable. They might know you as the person who ended up getting your car repoed. They might know you as the person who lost your place. They might know you as the person whose husband is out cheating on them or wife is making a fool out of them. They might know you as the person who baby daddy don't take care of their kids. They might know you as the person who got 10 different baby daddies. They might know you as the person, hallelujah, who is always angry and upset. They might know you as the person who was raped as a child. They might know you as the person who was always getting locked up. They might know you as the person who was sprung out on drugs. They might know you as the person. Somebody put that in the comment section. That was the way they labeled the old me. Somebody put in the comment section, that's my old label. You knew me as the person I was. But Genesis 12 and 2 told me that God said that he will make you into a great nation and that he will bless you, that he will make your name great and you will be a blessing. So if the Lord is making my name great, that means all the tests that I've been through and all the hell that I've been through, Jesus Christ, was for my testimony. I don't know who needs to hear this, but the way they would ever go shy, they labeled you back then. The Lord is saying it's non-negotiable. It's not up for debate. Why? Because what God is getting ready to do for you next is about to be mind-blowing. You're about to go from, oh, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, the homeless person, people of God, to the person of a Messiah who are owning different things. You're about to go from the person who was catching Uber and using public transportation to the person who's driving the nice foreign car. God is saying, I am making your name great. Watch this, people of God. The enemy is upset because the enemy is defeated. I want to leave you with that on today, that God is preparing a table in the presence of your enemies. Whatever is trying to break you down, your enemy don't have to be a person. Psalms 23:5 says this: you'll prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies, and then you will anoint my head with oil, and my cup will overflow. Remember, people of God, I told you that it wasn't until today, and I read this scripture over and over and over again, but it wasn't until today that God began to give me a new revelation of it. When the Lord is saying he's preparing a table in the presence of your enemies, people of God, it don't just mean people. It don't just mean all the people, hallelujah, who did you wrong. No, no, no. It don't just mean all the people who doubted you. It don't just mean, hallelujah, all the people who counted you out. God is saying it's so much bigger than that. This table, people of God, it's big enough to hold a feast. The Lord is saying everything will be at the table, hallelujah, that has been hindering you lately. Everything will be at the table, hallelujah, people of God. Watch this, that Rabakoshiah has gotten the worst version of you. Everything will be at the table that has tried to break you down and defeat you. I read that scripture 100 times, that the Lord, watch this, was preparing a table for you in the presence of your enemies. And I always thought it was the backstabbers that was going to be at the table. But the Lord said, no, you are an enemy of anything that has been trying to break you down. I don't know who needs to hear this message on today, but I told you today's message was, it's non-negotiable. It's no longer up for debate. Hallelujah. Somebody put in the comment section, my blessings are no longer up for debate. Come on, pray that over yourself. Decree that over yourself. My blessings are no longer up for debate. There are two things, people of God, that I'm getting ready to ask you to do. Today's message was, it's non-negotiable. Whatever you're believing God for, prepare. Hallelujah. Watch this. Prepare for the Lord to do it. It's no longer up for debate. Whatever you're needing God to do, I want you to take the next 60 seconds, the next minute, and drop it in the comment section. The first thing I'm going to need for you to do, people of God, is begin to pray and ask God, should you give into my ministry? Do not sow unless the Lord is telling you to give. There are some of you that are watching. You say, Dr. Shakir McFadden, I got to sow the Psalm 23:5 seed that stated you'll prepare a table for me in the presence of my enemies, and then you'll anoint my head with oil and my cup will overflow, because you've given me a different version of it. Your bills may be your enemy. Your relationship may be the enemy. Anywhere, anything that you're going through that is trying to mentally break you down, God said it's no longer up for debate. I am taking care of it. So there are some of you that are going to sow $23.50. They're going to sow $23.50, hallelujah, for you, and you're going to sow it for each one of your children also. You say the attacks are no longer up for debate. I've been going through this thing for too long. If you're giving, the ways to give is on the top of the screen for TikTok and the bottom of the screen on Facebook. Pray, 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 and ask God, should you give? Please do not sow into my ministry unless the Lord has released you to, because I need your faith to line up with what I'm speaking over your life. $23.50. Come on, we're sowing a Psalms 23 and 5 seed. And as you begin to sow the $23.50, I want you to put in the memo section, it's non-negotiable. Struggling financially, after the day, it's non-negotiable. God has to do it for you. Come on, come on. Living from pillar to post, after today, it's non-negotiable. God has to give you a place with your own address so you can get mail there with your own name on it. I'm speaking it. Do you receive it? Divorce, it's non-negotiable. Separation, it's non-negotiable. God shall mend it. Do you believe? The second thing I want you to do is not pay attention to the comments. There are certain things you need to go to God for yourself. There's a bunch of people sowing right now. Come on, I want you to begin to sow. The phone number is at the bottom of the screen on TikTok. That is for Cash App, Chime, Zelle, PayPal, or Venmo. 754-246-0580. Come on, if you're sowing via Cash App, put in the full phone number to Dr. Shakira M. Pop-Up. I got on a black dress. Put in the full phone number to Dr. Shakira M. Pop-Up. They've made fake Cash Apps of me. If you're doing Zelle, Gum Ministries with Pop-Up, G-U-M for God, use me. Chime, same phone number. PayPal, same phone number. Venmo, same phone number. It's too many ways to give for you to miss this blessing. Apple Pay is the only thing with a different number. If you are sowing via Apple Pay, it's 954-245-7379. There are some of you, you're going to sow the $23.50 for you and $23.50 for your health. There are some of you, you're going to sow $23.50 for the house keys and $23.50 for your bills. There are some of you, you're going to sow the $23.50 for you and $23.50 for each person who lives in your household, because you say, God, I need you to move. But there are some of you that are watching. You say, Dr. Shakira McFadden, if I can be honest with you, if I sold the $23.50 for every issue I have, I'll be sowing all day long. You say the tax on me are much greater, so I need a way to sow an all-around seed. You say I want to sow the $23.50, but I want to sow an all-around seed instead of $123.50. And you say I'm sowing the all-around seed because I need to put this seed in the ground, this big seed in the ground. I need to put this stretch in the ground for God to do it in every area of my life. If you're sowing the $123.50, I want you to put in the memo section, God, do it everywhere. If you're sowing the $23.50, you're putting non-negotiable. It's okay, Nye. At the end of every live, I save it and upload it to my YouTube channel, Shakira McFadden. Come on, come on, begin to sow. If you sowed, I want you to comment below, I sowed. I want you to comment below, I sowed. There are so many people who sow and they get off before I can even bless their seed with a prayer. Please make sure you stay on. Come on, come on. Some of you, it's going to be $23.50. Some of you, it's going to be $123.50. If you are somebody who's going through it in your relationship and you need God to deal with the other person's mind or heart, I want to challenge you to sow the $123.50. And in the memo section, when you sow the $123.50, I want you to put you and your significant other's name there. Come on, begin to sow. If you are believing God for any type of keys, I want to challenge you to sow the $123.50. Whether it's a house key, a car key, whether you need business funding to open your own business. Come on, that's a key you need. I want to challenge you to sow the $123.50. Come on, there are some of you, you genuinely don't have it. The Lord will still bless you. But there are others who say, I got to sow my way out of this. I got to put some speed on my seed because I've been challenged with this thing for too long. Father God, right now in the name of Jesus, I pray for every person right now. who genuinely didn't have a seed to give. I ask that you bless them, oh God. God, I ask that you show up and show out in their lives like never before. I pray, God, for every person right now, Lord God, who sold the $23.50 or the $123.50. I ask, Lord God, that you begin to move in their lives like never before. That the very thing they're needing you to do is not up for debate. Father, I thank you that they will see miracles, signs, and wonders. Every person who have tuned in on today, where they will know that they specifically heard from you. God, hide me behind the cross so you get all the glory. I cover their seeds under the blood of Jesus. I thank you, Lord Abakoshaya, God, for the upcoming praise report. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Come on and begin to comment it. Apple Pay is the only thing with a different phone number. Come on, comment. Amen, amen, amen. Okay, I see the woman of God said, I'm sowing now. Okay, go ahead, Kay. 954-245-7379. That was the phone number for Apple Pay. But if you are sowing via Cash App, Chime, Zelle, PayPal, or Venmo, it's 754-246-0580. Please put in the full phone number on Cash App until you see Dr. Shakira M. I got on a black dress. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Begin to give. The woman of God say, I sold $10. That was all I had. God know your heart. May the Lord bless it. May it come back a thousandfold. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Tune in tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern Time on Facebook. On TikTok, it's 10:15 p.m. Eastern Time because I build an audience on Facebook first. 10:15 p.m. on Eastern Time on TikTok tonight. 10 p.m. Eastern Time on Facebook. I love you guys. God bless you. I'm going to end over on TikTok first. Glory be to God. And now I'm going to end over on Facebook. I love you. God bless you. Have a great day.